John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Little did I know that the first thing I learned at such a young age would prove to play such an important part in me becoming a Christian and getting saved this year in January 2020. I've been very thankful and grateful to be introduced to God at such a young age. I was sent faithfully to Sunday school, morning church service, church in the evening when I was the age to go, also the young fellowship, part of a wee free Presbyterian church, and also children's meeting. And then I was also sent to the Ebenezer in the afternoon, so I had a real good upbringing when it come to knowing God and the Bible. But as years pass by and you know you get older and you're introduced to the ways of the world, and for example, like, you know, if we're away out the weekend with the young fellowships, I would have went to say it was 10 pound bowl and maybe something to eat, but then afterwards, you know, I always would have went out then to the nightclub or something after. So I was kind of maybe what I felt was getting the best of both worlds, was attending church and doing things, and then I was going out afterwards. As time passed then, you know, I stopped with the young folks and, you know, maybe only going to church 3 or 4 times a year, and maybe the odd family service. My mum asked me, or the children's Sunday to watch my boys perform and things like that. So kind of just grew out of a way of going to church. But I remember something that always stuck in my mind. I had a kind of difficult stage in my life, and I took the boys one Sunday to Bangor Picnic Park, and we were on the swans and things, and that night I went to church, and my sister says when you turn to Deuteronomy chapter 14, and as we're reading down through the passage, came to verse 16 and I seen the word swan, and I just said to myself, oh, that was it. I was on the swans this afternoon, and that always stuck in my mind. But the time passed, I just kind of, you know, forgot about it, but it was always there in my mind. You know, any time I went to church, I was always kind of thinking, oh, I wonder, will this relate to something that I had maybe done through the week, or something that I had been thinking. So in the past few years then, I had some more difficult times in my life and things like that. And I went on a trip, and with quite a lot of other Christians, and I kind of, when I come home from it, I kind of been, you know, wanting to go to church more, and I'm wanting to kind of find out more about being a Christian. And you know, even the way I knew what I needed to do to be saved, it was just something that I kept saying, oh, I need to go to church more, and you know, what did I expect would happen? I was searching. So then I gave a team talk to my footballers one day on disappointment and what is disappointment. And you're only disappointed if you expect more than what you get. And he then came back to me the week after and said, your team talk went into the car on Monday morning, and there was a pastor and he was preaching on disappointment. And I kind of thought to myself, I wonder, is he the man I need to speak to? You know, because I had been like soul searching for answers. So I was attending church more regularly. I was going, and I was looking for more answers. So I went to the Free Presbyterian. We're having a mission, and I always took my Bible that I had from years ago. Always had a few wee memory verses in it, and a few marks in my Bible. So this one particular mission, the minister then says, can you turn to Galatians chapter 6, and I had a wee slip of paper, Galatians chapter 6, verse 7, so that just made me think. You know, I didn't really listen to the service, but it was just going through my mind, you know, why did I have that wee bit of paper? You know, why did the minister turn the passage, had the swan in it? The team talked about disappointment, so nearly every church service I was going to, I was looking for, you know, for something to relate to something I had in my Bible. And a real big turning point was then I went to the Free one Sunday night, and that was the students from the Whitfield College were preaching, and they said, can you turn to Romans chapter 8? And I had that particular page, a wee pen mark on it, for whatever reason, from years ago. And same thing again. Oh, God speaking to me, but I left the meeting and never done nothing about it. But not next week, then I went to Ballywalter, and through the week they were having a mission. And believe it or not, the first service, minister went to speak, and he said to, can you turn to Romans chapter 8, 16 page on the mark. So, I mean, I was just taken aback, and I just couldn't believe, but I knew he was speaking to me, but still, I got up and I left that meeting. So, it was then, and fast forward then to the start of the year, January, that's the 19th, Sunday the 19th, and I went to Clarty Church, Jean, her mum, to listen to Jill. She was giving her sister Jill, she was giving a talk on what she had done in Swaziland and things like that. So there was also one of my players that played for Porto Vogue, he was playing guitar and singing, and singing For God So Loved the World, the song that's on in the background, and Jill was doing her talk and different bits and pieces, and I just lump in my throat and tears in my eyes, and I just felt this real strong feeling over me. But anyway, I left the meeting and went home as I usually did, and but it was in my mind all day and that evening, and thinking about it and whatever else. But I went to bed, and about 11, half 11, I could not sleep. I was as restless as anything, and I got my phone, and I was listening to songs on my phone, and For God So Loved the World, I put that on, and I just started crying. The tears would trip me. I was just thinking about my sons and would I give any of them up, which God did with his son and for us, and I wouldn't, and I knew that was the time I needed to be saved. And I got out of my bed and I asked God to save me, I asked him to forgive me, and I just felt such a peace and contentment that I'd never had before, and I just couldn't wait till the next morning to tell Jane and my mum and my brother and my sister, and to tell everybody that I had been saved. I would like to just take this opportunity at the end just to say to anybody, if you're praying for people, and you know, to keep praying, and prayer is powerful, and the amount of people who after it said they were praying for me for years, and they knew that I was under conviction. So if you're praying and keep doing it, I would like to just leave you with a verse from Psalm 28 verse 7. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusteth in him, and I am helped. Therefore my heart greatly rejoiceth, and with my song will I praise him. Thanks for listening. Take care, and God bless.